Hello, today I'm going to try and explain the definition of a real vector space. We were doing this in linear algebra last Thursday and I guess some people got thrown off. Okay, so let me go over the definition again. So I explained in class that usually you will see me writing a real vector space as this notation, okay? I have V, circle plus, and circle times. That just means to say I'm looking at a set V. A set consists of elements, right? And then on this set V, we are going to perform two operations. The first operation we can denote by circle plus, okay? And the second operation we denote by circle times. All right. Now, we are going to be given sets and we are going to verify whether these sets under the two defined operations are going to be vector spaces, all right? And these are the 10 conditions we have to check, all right? So we have, I don't know if you can see purple, condition A and condition B are the two most important things we need to check, okay? What does condition A say? Let's read it. It says, if you get any two elements U and V in the set V, and we will denote our elements by the vector notation, okay? In the book, it uses boldface letters, but it's easier when I write to just put the vector notation on top. So let's look at condition A. Condition A says if you take any two vectors or elements of V, which I will call vectors, okay, U and V in V, then when you apply the first operation to these two elements, the answer should also be in V, okay? So this is what we call closure of circle plus, okay? Of V under circle plus, or we say that V is closed under that first operation that we define. So that's very important to check first, because if that doesn't hold, it's really pointless to check these four conditions under it, okay? The next important condition to check is condition B. Condition B now has something to do with the second operation, which is circle times. Now, circle times, how it works is you take an element U in V, okay, so it's a vector, okay, so it's a vector element in V, and then you take any real number C. C is just a real number, all right, and what you want to see is when you apply C circle times U, that vector U, the answer is also in V, okay, so that's the meaning of A and B. So first check these two, because yeah, it's kind of like showing you, if you check A and B, if you have valid operations, okay? Can you even perform circle plus on any two elements of V? So again, I want to point out, circle plus you use for at least two elements of V, okay? Circle times is something you perform on a real number and an element of V, okay? So that's what's happening there. Okay, then after you have checked closure of circle plus and circle times, what you have to do is check the four conditions here. These four actually correspond to the first operation, circle plus, okay? So let's just briefly go through each one. The first says U circle plus V is equal to V circle plus U for any U and V in V. That just means to say what? That the first operation you define is commutative. All right, so you can switch the order. The second condition says if you have U circle plus the quantity V plus W, that should equal the quantity U plus V circle plus W for any U, V, and W in V. And again, you recognize that this is just the associative property for that operation circle plus. All right, third condition here that you need to check is you must be able to find, so this symbol is there exists, okay? There exists a zero vector in V. This zero vector is really, maybe a better name for the zero vector is, it's really an identity element. An identity element in V, because if you look at the next property, it says, such that when you apply zero to the U under the circle plus operation, or vice versa, if you can also switch the order. If you have zero circle plus U, you preserve the identity of U. All right, so that's what this means. It's kind of like your additive identity for real numbers, right? But again, when we look at examples later on, the zero is not necessarily going to look like a zero, okay? So this is property number 3. The way I would remember this is Under circle plus, there is an identity element for that operation, circle plus. Okay? Number four is, if you have any element U in V, okay, you should be able to find a negative U, okay? So that kind of is like your inverse, right? You might as, maybe you can call it your circle plus inverse of U in V, such that when you perform U circle plus minus U, which is the same as minus U circle plus U, you'll get the identity zero, okay? So these four properties relate to the circle plus operation. All right, now we go down and look at B. Okay, so next let's show 5, 6, 7, and 8. They mainly relate to this circle times operation, okay? So the first one says, number 5 says, if I have C circle times the quantity U circle plus V, so what you're doing here is you're performing the first operation on U and V, okay? And then getting C circle times of that answer. What this is saying is it's the same as applying C first, circle times U, and C circle times V, getting these two first before doing circle plus. And if you look at this, number 5 really just looks like a distributive property, right, of circle times over circle plus. All right, so that's the property number 5. You can think of it as distributivity of circle times over circle plus. Number 6, if you look, is kind of like a distributive property also, okay? But here I have two scalars or two real numbers, C and D. Notice I have C plus D. This is not a mistake, okay? This is not a circle plus. Well, because remember, circle plus applies to elements of V, okay? C and D are real numbers, okay? They are the scalars, not the vectors, okay? So C and D are just going to be added regularly. This is regular addition, okay? And then the result, U, do circle times U, okay? U is an element of V. What this property is saying is you can apply C circle U first, do that first, and then do D circle U next, and then these two results you can combine by doing circle plus. Notice here that this is an element of V. This is also an element of V, right? So you have two elements of V that you can combine using your defined circle plus operation, okay? So number 7, we have C circle times the quantity D circle times U. This is the same as CD circle times U. So again, let's see. What this is saying is you can do D circle times U first, okay? To that answer, you do C circle times whatever that is, okay? So you can do it one at a time, or you can perform multiplication. Again, let me point out here, this is CD, and there's nothing in between C and D. C and D are just real numbers, okay? This, what we have is regular multiplication. It's ordinary multiplication of the two numbers CD, okay? And then that product, you now get circle times with U, okay? Which is going to be defined. And then number 8, we have 1 circle times U is equal to U. So this kind of like is your identity. Remember in number 3. Number 3, we had the identity element for circle plus, right? We call that identity element circle plus, for circle plus, the zero vector, right? I want to point out here for circle times, okay, the identity element is written as 1 without any bar on top, any vector notation on top. So it's not like that, meaning to say 1 is always going to be 1 for this case, okay? The identity element for circle times is always going to be the number 1, all right? And that's the difference. And I know I gave an example last meeting where you got thrown off because the zero vector was something else. So I want to point out that's here it kind of like just means a symbol, okay, for the identity for circle plus. But here, the number 1 is the identity element for circle times, okay? So I hope that clarified the definition of a real vector space. Yeah, it's unfortunate that, yeah, we call circle plus vector addition, just because, right? That's the term for it. But you guys saw that it doesn't have to be addition, and circle times is called scalar multiplication. And the next thing we'll do is we'll give you a few examples of how to verify these conditions. Again, to reiterate, A and B are closure properties, okay? The first four are pretty easy to remember. Commutative for plus, associative for plus, right? Existence of an identity element for plus, circle plus, okay? Existence of an inverse for circle plus. And 5, 6, 7, and 8 are four more of the distributive properties of scalar multiplication and, yeah, associative property here as well. But these are two scalars, and that's a vector. And the identity element for circle times. Okay, so hope you understood that, clarify that definition of real vector space.